This program was produced by Now You Know Media. Lectures are about 25 minutes in length and are designed to fit conveniently into your daily routine while commuting, exercising, or at home. We search the world for trusted expert presenters, record them in our studios, and deliver their knowledge to you whenever and wherever you desire. We invite you to visit our website, nowyouknowmedia.com, to explore our newest programs. This course is entitled, What Would You Like to Know About Catholicism? Your professor is Father William J. Byron, S.J., Ph.D. Dr. Byron is a professor of business and society at St. Joseph's University in Philadelphia. He is the past president of the Catholic University of America and of the University of Scranton, and he served as interim president of Loyola University in New Orleans for the academic year 2003-2004. He holds a doctorate in economics from the University of Maryland, two theology degrees from Woodstock College, a bachelor's degree, a licentiate in philosophy, and a master's degree in economics from St. Louis University. The author of 10 books and the editor of two, Father Byron writes the bi-weekly syndicated column Looking Around for Catholic News Service and a monthly What Would You Like to Know feature for Catholic Digest. His 1989 book, Quadrangle Considerations, won the Catholic Press Association's Best Book Award in the education category.
Welcome to our course, What Would You Like to Know About Catholicism? My name is William Byron. I'm a Jesuit priest. I've been a priest for a long time. I was ordained in 1961. I joined the Jesuits in 1950. I'm a GI generation guy. I had been in the Army in 1945 and 46, later went to college, and then reflected in my collegiate years what my vocation was, and I discerned that I was called to priesthood in the Society of Jesus. As a Jesuit, I've had a good education. I've had advanced work in philosophy and theology, and I was sent off to do a doctorate in economics, and I've taught economics, social ethics. I've been in the college classroom way back early in my Jesuit career. I spent two wonderful years, in a prep school classroom. You'll be hearing references to that as we go through the course. But the point of this is to address interests that Catholics have and may state in the form of a question. What would you like to know about Catholicism? I've been thinking in terms of Catholic considerations. There are a lot of things that Catholics want to consider. Even that word considera, sidera, the plural for stars, con with the stars. Let your mind stretch out, because this is an adult education course for Catholics, many of whom feel the need for updating as well as a theological tune-up 10, 20, or more years out of school. Another way of thinking about this is in terms of what you might want to talk about with your friends, how to prepare yourself with answers to questions that might come from non-Catholic friends, or what you should be talking about with your offspring, especially when they become young adults. There's going to be a broad range of contemporary social, theological, ethical, and educational issues that we'll be covering, and I'd like to get to that simply by setting up for you, if you will, a menu of what we're going to be doing in the subsequent presentations. The presentation under the heading of 10 Building Blocks of Catholic Social Teaching comes in response to questions that sometimes are asked about what does it mean to have a preferential option for the poor, or some say, is social doctrine an essential part of the Catholic faith? Well, our bishops certainly think so, and I'm going to be laying that out in what I call 10 building blocks. Now, I won't elaborate on them now, I'll just mention that we'll be looking at the principle of human dignity. We'll be looking at the respect for human life, the principle of respect for human life, a principle of association, that you have the right to associate in groups, the principle of participation and the importance of participating in our own political processes in a representative democracy, the principle of solidarity, that we are locked hand in hand by virtue of our common and shared human nature. We're locked hand in hand with people of all races, colors, languages all around the world. Something to think about. There's a special Catholic social principle of subsidiarity, which I like to refer to as the principle that keeps government in its place. There is, of course, a place for government, the preservation, protection of right order, the protection and advancement of the common good. The principle of subsidiarity simply says that no decision should be taken at a higher level that can be taken effectively and efficiently at a lower level of organization. That's what the principle of subsidiarity is all about, and we'll be discussing that. I'll mention when I'm doing the building blocks the notion of stewardship, but I'll be devoting an entire presentation to that important concept. Similarly, the idea of justice, so central to our Catholic understanding of our tradition and our world, and understanding justice will be the topic of a full presentation, in this series. The preferential option for the poor, a preferential protection for the poor, is part of our Catholic tradition, and we'll be talking about that throughout this course, but that's one of the building blocks. And the 10th building block is the principle of the common good. We'll devote an entire session to that, and we'll be mentioning it in passing. There are a number of Catholics who are interested in the relevance of their religious faith to what they do Monday through Friday, 9 to 5 or longer, and we'll be looking at that in the context of workplace spirituality, but under the heading of Sunday into Monday. We'll be exploring the relevance of the Catholic faith commitment to everyday working life, and in the process, we'll be learning perhaps a bit more of what it really means to be a Catholic in a down-to-earth, practical, workaday sense. Then after doing that, we'll have a separate presentation reversing the order and going Monday into Sunday. Looking at the work week, I like to suggest it as the beginning of an offertory procession. And looking at work and our participation in the development of created reality as part of our growth, our responsibility, and indeed picking up gifts along the way. The gifts of kindnesses received, the gift of kindness rendered. The gifts of goods or services received, the gifts of goods and services rendered. And gathering that up, so to speak, and carrying it before the altar on the following Sunday and offering it to God in praise and thanks as we invoke God's blessing for the week ahead. Is there such a thing as a vocation to business? That's going to be one of our presentations. So often we think narrowly of vocation as vocation of priesthood or religious life, but a vocation is a call. And there is indeed a call to be an accountant, a call to be a dentist, a call to be a lawyer, a call to be a truck driver, a call to have an occupation where we work by God's grace, exist by God's grace, and not only make a living, but also reflect glory and praise to God by using our talents for the making of that living for ourselves and others. How about the notion of spirituality? There's a distinction between religion and spirituality. We'll be looking at that in presentation number 6. Exploring the difference between religion and spirituality. So many people think of religion in terms of Gothic architecture and stained glass windows, but they seem, by their own account, often to be much more comfortable with spirituality. And we'll be exploring that range of comfort, and we'll be talking about the importance of spirituality in a human life.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.